cantaloupe. I like to make today sugar cookies, which is we cut them into hand shape cookies and decorate it with painted nails. So what we do is for simple sugar cookie recipe, it's very good recipe, it's very easy to make and it's practically never fails. So what we need is, we need 1.5 sticks, which is about 3/4 cup of softened unsalted butter. As you can see, it's nice and soft. We place it already in a bowl and we add 3/4 cup of sugar. It's about 150 grams. So we add butter and sugar, and what we do is next we beat together with electric beaters until they nicely incorporated and butter change color. Once our butter change colors, you can see it's become much paler. And what we do is next, it's only take few minutes to beat butter and sugar together. So next step is to add one large egg and 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence or vanilla extract. So what we do is again we beat together and then we add flour. Once egg and vanilla essence being incorporated, next step is add flour. We need 2 1/4 cups of plain or all-purpose flour, depend which country you live in, but it's just a normal plain flour. So we add in it. It's about 250 gram. All ingredients I will place in the description box. Have a look if you're interested. And 1/4 teaspoon of salt. So what we do is we on low speed just incorporate it. If you find it is difficult, simply using spoon to incorporate it flour and salt into butter mixture. Good idea to preheat oven to 180 degrees Celsius, which is 350 Fahrenheit. And we have two baking trays lined with non-stick baking paper. So what we do is, next step is once your dough come together, basically in a bowl. So I was using electric mixer in just a low speed. It just took a few seconds and the dough comes together beautifully. So next step is I'm using half of cookie dough because it's easier to work with. I use this sort of hand cookie cutter. I saw you feel like you can use a little bit smaller for the girls. And what we do is we just dust a little bit our cookie cutter and we roll out our sugar cookie dough into about 1/4 inch or 0.5 centimeter in a thickness. So what we do is next we just start cut out basically all the cookies. So place them nicely onto your baking tray and just proceed with all the cookies, as many as you can make, of course. And as I said before, if you like to make it for girls, make it a bit smaller and they can decorate it into their favorite character also. So let's finish to cutting out all our cookies. Once you cut out all your cookies, re-roll all leftovers and cut cookies again until all cookie dough is finished. So basically it just depends what sort of size cookie cutter you using, if you use a medium size or larger one. In general, if you're using 2.5 type of inch cookie cutter, you will get about 2 dozen of cookies roughly. So what we have, 2 trays with a little bit larger hand and 1 tray with a smaller one. It just depends what sort of cookie cutter you able to find. Does not really matter because it will work on any. So what we do is next we place in our preheated oven, as I said before, 180 degrees Celsius, which is ready now, and we bake for 10 minutes. Then take once cookies are baked, place them on a cooling rack to completely cool down. When sugar cookies are baked, as you can see, they still have very nice shape, which is just what we want. We don't want them actually lose their shape. This type of sugar cookie recipe, which really, really great for any kind of, especially decorating type of cookies. So, as you can see, they will now nicely cool down. And what next we have to do is use a fondant or ready to roll icing. It's really not much difference. If you have in your country fondant, it's great. So what we do is roll out on your working surface, sprinkle with a powdered icing sugar to prevent sticking. And to make our nails, it's a number of ways. I using 1 centimeter, 1/2 inch in a diameter nozzle to cut out the basically nails from a fondant. So we just cut out as many as we want. I just push it gently because it just makes still keep it shape. That's what we really wanted. And as you done them, as you can see, they come out nice and round, but we won't make them to the nail shape what we really want. So we slightly press them together, slightly squash them to make more prolonged shape. Then what we do is flatten. And once again, we slightly press 2 sides together to make more oval, prolonged shape, and flatten. So we continue with the rest of our fondant nails. Like this, you will have exactly same nails, and they will look great on while you decorate them. And so another way, if you want to do, just fold foil, aluminium foil, many times over, about 3-4 times, make sure it's nice and basically hard, like sort of you're able to actually bend it. So bend over together. Yeah, just was wondering, do I have to show from start or not? Once we fold them, as you can see, we make it a nail basically shape. So if you make them longer, you can do so if you wanted using this particular type of shape. Then you can get any shape what you really want. And I saw they will be same as well. So you can make them from foil also. But you, as I said, you can always use the any kind of nozzle which just fits simply to look at, if you look at on the actual nail, because even if it's slightly larger, that's okay, because we slightly flatten them, press them together to make it more prolonged shape anyway. So once we've done all of that, what we do is next, we simply decorate now the our nails. To decorate the fondant nails, use your own design or print it from internet or whatever you like it. If you're making cookies for little girls, you can use it since like, for example, I just come closer to make sure. For example, rainbow, for example, or little type of donuts, chocolate glazed donuts, or many other variety. So what we do is, once it's slightly dry, just a little bit, it's okay. So what we do, if you like to make nails with the hundreds and thousands or sprinkles, as I said before, it just depends which country you live, and place a small amount of sugar syrup. You can even use a liquid type of honey as well, and brush it to cover entire area. Press it into sprinkles. And here we are. We have already just get rid of excess if it's any sprinkles attached. And here we are. We have already beautiful nail basically, which is decorated with sprinkles, look like rainbow also. So next one we can do is we can use edible pink type of dust or rainbow dust, depends on your choice. And what we do exactly same thing. We apply on top of one side, entire area, with a sugar syrup, and press into sprinkles. And as you can see, we have very beautiful shiny nail. So next is, you can make anything, even basically draw paper pig as well. Number variety, you can use the gel liquid, gel food coloring, any kind of colors you prefer, or use a packet of food decorating pens, which is edible food decorating pens, especially designed to write on a fondant. So, for example, to the make a rainbow, we start with the blue pen. Followed by yellow. Of course, any kind colors you can apply much more if you prefer to do so. It's a great activity to do with children, because girls especially like decorate their nails, and it gives them opportunity to express themselves and do entire decoration by themselves, which is also not messy, and it's very, very easy to do. So we follow blue, yellow, orange, red, and finish up with blue, which is we actually make little on a tip, leave it as a white, as a cloud. Now let's have a look. Here we are. It's very easy, very fast, and it's very attractive as well, at least in my eyes. As you can see, here we are. We have beautiful rainbow nail. So what we do is to basically let them dry to make sure it's no smudges or anything like that. And it doesn't take very long, just a few minutes. And then we can take our cool down cookie and use something, sugar syrup, and just on end of the our biscuit nails, we apply sugar syrup. Then we can apply all ready fondant nails. So we slightly press them in. We have and replace also this one will be different one all. Once you're done, just slightly up, a little bit press, just a little bit. Just make sure they stay on the place and let them set. Shape it also as you go. So what we do is, we can have a look now on our already done. Cookies, hands with decorated as a with decorated nails. As you can see, we have a little heart with a smiley face, little diamonds, various things which is girls really really like it. A little star with a smiling face as well. Plenty of the beautiful pink sprinkles, and this is as a rainbow type of nails, and this one, for example, easily can be done as a your favorite Facebook or Twitter or YouTube, whatever you prefer from social media, or simply decorate them with rainbow sprinkles. This one, for example, a donut, which is basically has chocolate glaze on top with the pink sprinkles. As you can see, they're really, really great, and this gives possibility for children to express themselves and make their own design. Thank you very much for your time with me today. I hope you do like this simple unusual recipe. Everything will be in the description box. Thank you for your time. Until next time, goodbye.